toss some hair down or something? Hello?
I should have worn my coat. Oh, great, I got one of the snoozers. Oh, that's nice. Well, let's go.
But wait, Sir Knight. I have long awaited this day, and I wouldest first like to knowest to the name of my champion.
Shrek.
Oh, Sir Shrek, I pray thee take this favor as a token of my gratitude.
Oh, thanks. Thanks. Now, where's the door?
There is no door.
What do you mean there's no door? How do we get there?
Why, the same way you came up.
The same way I come up. Oh, come on. All right. Come on, let's go.
No, but hold us on, Sir Knight. Don't you want to savor this moment? It beeth our first meeting. It must be a wonderful and romantic scene.
It's on my to-do list.
Yeah. great and thine heart is pure. I am forever in your debt. Oh, and what would a brave knight be without his noble steed?
All right, I hope you heard that. She called me a noble steed. She's on the steed.
Well, Sir Shrek, the battle is won. You may remove your helmet.
No.
Why not?
I have helmet hair.
Please, I would just like to look upon the face of my rescuer.
Oh, no, you wouldn't.
But how will you kiss me?
What? What? That wasn't in the job description.
Maybe it's a perk.
No. It's destiny. A princess is rescued by a brave knight, and then they share true love's first kiss.
True love? With Shrek. You think that Shrek is your true love?
Isn't that funny?
Well, let's just say I'm not your type, okay?
Of course you are. You're my rescuer. Now, remove your helmet.
No, I really don't think that's a good idea.
Just take off the helmet.
Well, I'm not going to.
Take it off.
No.
Now!
Okay. All right. As you wish, Your Highness.
Ogre.
What, are you expecting Prince Charming?
Well, yes, actually. Oh no, I was supposed to be rescued by my true love, not some ogre and his pet. You're not supposed to be an ogre.
Look, Princess, I'm just here to rescue you. Lord Farquhar's the one who sent me. He wants to marry you.
Oh, then why didn't he come?
That's a great question. Why don't you ask him tomorrow?
Tomorrow? Oh my gosh, it's almost sunset.
So?
I didn't realize it was so late. We need to make camp.
Make camp? We just escaped.
Yes, I know, and I found the whole ordeal quite exhausting. We need to find a place to rest immediately.
Well, that's very nice. We're gonna keep going.
I need to find somewhere to camp right now!
Okay. A cave right there.
Shrek, that cave's no place for no princess.
No, it's perfect. I bid thee good night, gentlemen.
Do you want me to read you a bedtime story?
I said good night.
She seems nice.
By day one way, by night another. This should be the norm until you find true love's first kiss, and then take love's true form.
Dragon, then we could do anything. Man, I could be a steed. Or I could even work one of those crusade circuits. I could even be one of those horses, pull those wagons full of beer. I'd need some hair extensions on my ankles, but I could do it. Who do you want to be?
I don't want to be anyone.
Just for fun, though. Who would you pick?
I wouldn't.
Like, if you had to. Like, if a guy had a sword at his throat and was like, look here, you could be an oak anymore. Then would you pick?
I would pick him up and hurl him into a tree.
Man, you are no fun at all. You know that? Is this what it's gonna be like when we finish rescuing the princess? Us sitting around our swamp all day doing nothing?
Our swamp! Dorky, there is no we! There is no us! It's just me! Me and my swamp! And the first thing I'm gonna do when I get back, I'm gonna build a 10-foot wall around my land.
You cut me deep, Shrek. You cut me real deep just now. What you got against the whole world anyway?
I'm not the one who has anything against the world. The world is the one who has something against me. You saw how the princess reacted. That's how it always is. They take one look at me, and it's, stupid, ugly ogre. They judge me before they even know me. That's why I'm better off alone.
Do you know, Shrek? When I first met you, I didn't think you was just a big, stupid, ugly ogre.
I know.
So there's really no one else you'd rather be?
Sammy lashing, a shield within my grip, or else I'd be a Viking and live a life of daring while smelling like a herring upon a Viking ship. I'd sail the sea, I'd see the world, I'd reach the farthest reaches, I'd feel the wind, I'd taste the salt and sea, and maybe storm some beaches. That's who I'd be. Or I could be a poet and write a different story, one that tells of glory and wipes away the lies. And to the skies I'd throw it, the stars would do the telling, the moon would help with spelling, the night would dawn the eyes. I'd write my verse, recite my joy, and with a perfect timing, confess the things, confess the things. Stays in the dark, you're all alone. So yes, I'd be a hero, and if I wish for granted, life would be enchanted, so the story seems. Of course I'd be a hero, and I would steal a tower, and save the hot house flower, and carry her away, and stand in guard. I'd somehow overwhelm it. I'd get the girl, I'd take my breath, and I'd remove my helmet. These diamonds, they always make up love. We'd see the stars descending. I'd share a kiss, I'd find my destiny. I'd have other heroes in me. A perfect happy ending. That's how it would be.
Stays in the dark.